Hey, what is up, Impact family? Pastor Matt here for another Sunday morning Impact video. Before we get started, I just want to quickly say, hey, shout out to you guys who are on the Zoom call on Wednesday night. We absolutely love being able to connect with you guys and have a good time. And even though I was in the other room on Wednesday, it was definitely awesome getting to listen in and learn a lot about you guys through Hannah's questions and the times in which you guys shared. I know Sis Joyce answered the question of what kind of superpower she would have or what kind of superpower she could choose for herself. It's always a blast on Wednesdays. So if you guys don't know, hey, Zoom Wednesdays at 7 p.m., just hit me up. I'll make sure that you guys get the link. We would love to connect with you as well. But if you guys didn't know, I'm actually sharing in main service today. So if you guys have time and you feel comfortable, come on down to the church, social distance and mask and all that's required at 10 a.m. Or of course, you can also connect online with us on YouTube or Facebook at 9 a.m. or 11 a.m. as well. Well, we're going to jump right into today's impact lesson. So let's do this. Matthew chapter 23 is what we're going to be talking about today. Well, Jesus is speaking and he's speaking to a large crowd, a crowd of people. And Jesus, over the crowds who had gathered to hear him speak, he could see these stone-faced men that were wearing expensive garments, expensive robes, and on the outskirts of the crowd, they were standing there. And Jesus knew who these men were. See, they were Pharisees. They were a group of religious leaders who took great pride in their obedience to all kinds of religious laws and regulations and actions. And they even did so much to where they strained their water so they would not accidentally swallow a gnat, which would be breaking the Jewish laws about eating unclean animals. They went all out to do all sorts of different things to make sure they followed the law to the T. But Jesus, he wasn't impressed by all of their efforts, by all these things that they did. In fact, he was actually angry at the Pharisees because the whole time that they were observing all the tiniest regulations and laws about things like washing their hands before they eat and how they could walk, how far they could walk on the Sabbath, and how far they couldn't walk. Well, their lives were actually filled with cruelty and unkindness to others. Yeah, they obeyed the law to the T, but yet their lives were still filled with unkindness and cruelty. Woe to you, is what Jesus said, speaking directly to those frowning men on the edges of the crowd. He referred to their habit of giving a tenth of even the tiniest parts of their income to God, while at the same time, they treated people unfairly, unmercifully, and unfaithfully. What he says in Matthew chapter 23, is he says, woe to you, teachers of the law and Pharisees, you hypocrites. You give a tenth of your spices, mint, dill, and cumin, but you have neglected the more important matters of the law, justice, mercy, and faithfulness. You should have practiced the latter without neglecting the former. You can see all this in Matthew chapter 23, verse 23, when he's talking to the crowd and he addresses the Pharisees. In other words, though, what Jesus was saying, he says, it's no good to make a point of obeying God in the tiniest detail if at the same time you disobey him in the more important areas of justice, mercy, and faithfulness. You can have all the right lingo. You can talk the right talk. You can say the right words at the right time. You can show up at the right times. You can show up early. You can even do the right things. But if you lack in justice, mercy, and faithfulness, well, it's all for naught. I want to encourage you guys today, just like Jesus says in that passage, you should have practiced the latter without neglecting the former. Just like Jesus said that to the Pharisees, I want to encourage you guys with that. Now, I'm obviously not saying that you guys who are watching this, that you guys are doing that. But the encouragement comes in the sense that I want to make sure that we, in fact, that we never get started doing that. That we never practice these actions, these laws, but yet lack in the things in which the Pharisees were lacking in. See, we should obey Jesus. We should live in a way that honors him. And part of that is excelling in justice, mercy, and faithfulness as well. So, in closing, don't get caught up in the motions. Don't have the right actions with the wrong heart. Instead, let's make sure that our hearts are set on Jesus first and foremost, above all else. And then our actions can and will fall in line after that. Impact, I love you guys so much. I can't wait to see you guys. Hopefully I see you guys on Zoom on Wednesday night, this upcoming Wednesday, 7 p.m. It is absolute blast. I'm praying for you guys. Hannah and I are praying for you. Your leaders are praying for you. We love you guys so much. I'm going to pray real quick. Father, I thank you for Impact. I thank you for those watching this video. God, I ask that you would just help us. Help us to put you first and foremost in everything. God, help us to not just talk about it or even just to do the actions. But God, help our hearts be in the right place. Father, just as Jesus said to the Pharisees, that they did all the right things, but yet they were still wrong. Father, help us do the right things by following you. Help our actions fall in alignment with your heart. God, I thank you so much. It's in Jesus' name. If you agree with me, would you say amen? Amen. Love you, Impact, so much.